Identify a suitable validation check that could be used for each piece of normal test data and describe how it would be used. Each validation check must be different. Test data for entering an email address, id27@cambridgeuniversity.com. We need to give the validation check name and the description of use. Validation can be defined as the checking of data to make sure that it is reasonable or within a certain set of bounds. Generally, we would apply validation checks on input fields. For example, when we are creating an account to a service, when we're filling out a form, or even filling out a questionnaire. There are a number of validation checks that we need to know. Let's quickly go through the important ones. The first validation check we have is called a range check. This assesses whether data is within one or two bounds. For example, if we're entering a percentage, it must be between 0 and 100. Any number entered outside of this range would be rejected by the range check. The next validation check we have is called a length check. The length check will check the number of characters that are present within the data. For example, when creating a new account on a website, the password we enter usually has to be greater than 8 characters long. The next validation check we have is the type check. The type check will ensure that data entered is of a particular data type. For example, if a form asks us to enter our name, it should not contain any letters, hence it should be a string data type. The next check we have is a presence check. The presence check is mostly used in forms to ensure that the field has been filled out. The form cannot be submitted if a field is left out that has a presence check. And the last validation check we have is a format check. A format check ensures that data is entered in a specific way. For example, if we're entering a date, we may want data to follow this format: the day, then the month, and then the year. If data does not follow this format, it will be rejected by the format check. Let's now go ahead and answer these questions. The first one we have gives us an email address. We can immediately rule out a number of validation checks. A range check would not be used, since there are no numbers involved. A length check could be used, since the length of an email address cannot be greater than a certain amount of characters. A type check would not be used, since an email consists of letters, numbers, and symbols. A presence check would not be used, since the question has not indicated the email address exists within a form and must be filled out. And a format check would not be used, since email addresses can have a number of different formats. So let's go ahead and fill in length check. And the description of a length check is that it counts the number of characters within the data to make sure it is not too long. The next question says test data for entering a year, 2021. Let's again go through each of our validation checks. It could be a range check, since we are working with a number. It can't be a length check, as the length check would only check the length of the data and not check if it is a valid year. A type check would not be useful, as data items such as 10,342 would still be accepted, even though this is not a valid year. A presence check again would not be used, since it does not specify anything about a form. And a format check would not be useful, since we're only working with a single or an atomic value. So let's go ahead and fill in range check. And the description of a range check is that it checks that the number entered fits within the given parameters. In this case, checks that the year is between 0 and the current year. The last question says test data for entering a name, Erickson Bauer. Again, we'll go through our validation checks. It would not be a range check, since we're not working with a number. It would not be a length check, since a name can be any length. It could be a type check from the reasons we discussed earlier. It wouldn't be a presence check, and it wouldn't be a format check, since names can have any format. Let's go ahead and fill in type check. And the description of a type check is that it checks the type of data entered to make sure there are no numbers in this case. And there we go, that is this question completed.